guys, and today I'm going to be doing a January favourites. I have not done one of these in over a year. I was actually going through my videos and checking how long it's been since the last favourites video I did. But yeah, it's been over a year and I think it's about time I did one. I wanted to start doing these again because every month I do have favourites of products and things that I love, and I just never have time, or I've never found the time to actually do it. But this year, since I'm getting my channel a little bit more organised, I am going to get into doing the favourites videos again. Firstly, I'm going to start off with beauty. The first thing is more of a comeback. I've had this for a while and as far as I know, you can't get it anymore. But it is the Love Hearts perfume in the scent Berry Blast, and I absolutely love this. I got this, I don't know, about 5 years ago? Maybe six? I'm not entirely sure. I got this with my Boots Beauty Points and it was only like £5 and it still has like the littlest bit left, and I've been saving it this whole time because they just don't sell them anymore. But this month I got it back out and I have been enjoying it, and it's just bringing back all those first memories. It's this very sweet scent, so if you don't really like sugary sweet scents, I wouldn't recommend this if you can find it anymore. I'm not entirely sure if it still exists anywhere. I kind of wanted to mention it because I love this scent. Next thing I got a fair few months ago, I'm not entirely sure, maybe October, September, around then. Boyshop were doing a sale of all their old stock and I picked up the Frosted Cranberry Sugar Scrub, and I hadn't used it until December time. I started using it around December and oh my gosh, it is, it's like one of my favourite scrubs from Body Shop ever. It smells heavenly. It just smells like really sugary sweet cranberry, and I just love to lather myself in it when I'm in the bath and just scrub it in, and it just leaves your skin feeling so soft. Not only that though, I do put a bit on my face and I end up licking my lips because it tastes so good as well. I could eat this tub. I know in December they did release a different scrub, but I'm not sure if it was cranberry. I think it was frosted berries, but it didn't smell the same and I much prefer this one. The next thing I got from a Glossy Box a while ago, I'm not sure which Glossy Box. I will find out and then I will link it below what month it was, but it's this Unani, I don't know, but it's a Dermo Defense face mask, and this is so relaxing, especially when you're really hot or you've just had a really hot bath and you just want to put something on that not only smells good, makes your skin feel so cleansed, but kind of just, I don't know, I can't really describe it. It's like, you know when you put alcohol sanitizer on your hands and it kind of melts into your skin and it feels good? This is what this feels like. It feels like that, and it just makes my skin feel so soft, so cleansed and nourished. You just feel so refreshed, especially before bedtime. I absolutely love this. Now we're moving on to makeup products, my favourite part of these kind of videos. I think I can guarantee you pretty much everything that I show you in this makeup section I have used every single day of January. And I'm not gonna lie, they are so good. The first thing I'm going to show you is the Max Factor Lasting Performance Foundation in Fair or 100. I'm running out of my NYX foundation and I really wanted something a little lighter and a little bit more hydrating. It's brand new as far as I'm aware because I haven't seen it before. This is pretty much an exact dupe of MAC's Studio Fix foundation in the shade NW10, because that's what shade I am. It's light to medium coverage, so it's not really high coverage like MAC is, but it's so hydrating on the skin, it lasts all day, and I feel that it's going to be one of my new everyday foundations. Like I love it. If I don't use my MAC or my NARS foundation, I use this, and yeah, I cannot recommend this enough. I hope they keep this around because I love it. I love it to bits. One of the new releases of January was the MAC Caitlyn Jenner collection, and this lipstick I mentioned in another video, I think it was my birthday video. I don't think I've ever found a lipstick that matches my natural tone of my lips, but better. This is like my lips but better lipstick, basically. and it's in a cream sheen. It's my favourite formula of MAC's. I absolutely love it. It's just this gorgeous, gorgeous nude. It's very pigmented, not heavy, but it's a nice consistency. But I seriously cannot recommend this one enough. I love it so much. It's just the perfect nude, the perfect consistency, and the perfect formula. And yeah, I absolutely, hands down, love this. Another thing that I got from a glossy box was this Amit Makeup Artist Colour Powder Blush in the shade 108. And this has been a holy grail of mine ever since I got it. Not only is it a really, really nice bronzer and a really, really nice blush, it's just perfect for contour, blush, and bronzing. I am wearing it today. It's kind of this reddish brownish shade, so in some lights it looks brown and some lights it looks like a reddish, like a blush shade, and it's just so nice. The formula is so good. Unfortunately, my compact actually smashed. One of the cats that we were fostering one time kicked it off my dressing table and it just smashed while the lid was closed, thankfully, so it didn't go everywhere on the floor. But I eventually fixed it, and yeah, pretty much brand new, just a little bit wibbly wobbly texture, but I love it so much. So I've been wanting to try the Balm highlighters for like forever, and finally when I went to London, as you guys know, I picked up the Mary Luminizer. I've been using this throughout every single day of January. I am not kidding when I say that. It's the go-to highlighter I've been using all month, and it's just this perfect, gorgeous, taupey gold natural shade. That's the best way I can describe it. As you guys, if you watch my London vlog slash haul, I did pick up the highlighter and the pan was quite wobbly in it, like it was loose. I returned it back at Debenhams and then picked this up on Phil Unique. I got it for cheaper because they had 10% off, so I was very chuffed about that. But the pan, as you can see, is not going anywhere. That's not going anywhere. But it's this very gorgeous, natural highlighter. I love it. And I am wearing that today. Look at the glow. It's stunning. If I can recommend any highlighter for first time users in general that just wants to splash a little bit more cash than the average drugstore highlighter, I completely, highly, highly recommend the Mary Luminizer. They come in three different shades, but this is perfect for highlighting. And I freaking love it. Now, I'm sorry if I butcher this name, because every time I try and say Ciate, oh my gosh, I did it. Okay, every time I say that name, I can't pronounce it right, and it drives me insane. The birthday video, I struggled so much, I gave up and just said Ciat the whole way, because I couldn't say it. See, that's what happens. But you probably guessed it by now. It's the palette by Ciate in collaboration with Chloe Morello, the Pretty Fun and Fearless palette. I cannot recommend this palette enough. It's perfect for your everyday eye looks and evening eye looks. I've been using every single shade. As you can tell, every single shade in this palette has been used. And I've been creating gold, bronzy looks, and natural nude looks, and then kind of the evening kind of cranberry looks, and I've been wearing these in the daytime and the evening time. Like, what I really love about this palette is that all the shades are so blendable, so milky milky smooth. I think I have to say the only one that has a little bit of fallout would have to be Vacay, but my absolute favorite shade has to be Dainty. It's just the perfect inner corner highlight. I love it. And Queen Bee, I cannot get enough of all of these brown shades. In fact, every single one, oh, it's so nice. It's just a really good palette. I'm so glad I got it for my birthday, because it's just stunning. It's just such a good range of products. If you can get your hands on this, get it. Just don't even think twice about it. You will not regret this purchase. I'm not even freaking kidding you. It's just such an awesome palette. You need this in your collection. I cannot recommend this enough. It's just so good. So I may be a little bit late on this bandwagon, but I think this was released November? December? I'm not sure. They are managed by the same company as Makeup Revolution and I Heart Makeup and those kind of brands from Superdrug. The new makeup brand that has been released in Boots is called Makeup obsession. You're probably looking at this and thinking, what the heck is that? But these are all little empty containers, shall we say, which used to have eyeshadows in, or blushes in, or bronzers in, or highlighters in. They have so many different things. I love this whole idea. Basically, Makeup Obsession have created this idea where you can go into Boots and create your own personalized palette. And what you do is you pick up the palette that you want. Here I have a medium-sized gold palette, and then I have a large palette too. And this one, as you can see, holds 6, and this one, as you can see here, holds 12. I just think this is such a really good idea, because you know when you get those palettes and some of the shades you don't use entirely, and some of them you think you're never ever going to use. This, you can choose exactly what shades you want in your palettes, depending on what kind of palette you're going for. So here I've gone with 6 of my favourite shadows that I think will work together, and I chose the gold palette for this because I just loved the gold. This retails for £6. You can get the same size palettes but in a cheaper format. I think the black one is like £4 and the white one's £4, but then you have a silver, a pink, and then this gold one, which are £6. So depending on how much you want to spend, it's entirely up to you what you want to go for. So here are my 6 go-to shades. First of all, let's just take a moment at how stunning this looks. Not only do these colours work well together, but the palette has a freaking huge mirror. It's the size of the lid, which I absolutely love about this. I chose 5 shimmer shades and then 1 matte shade. So from left to right, we have Champagne, and that is the E109. E stands for eyeshadow, I presume. So E109 in Champagne. Then we have E120 in Rich, and then we have E107 in Rare, and then Precious Metal is E119. Then we have here in the middle is E111 in Cosmo, and then we have E101 called Burnt. I didn't think the quality of these products were going to be any good, but I stood there swatching them on my hand, and then I put some highlighters on my face and eyeshadows. They are so worth it. The price of the individual eyeshadows is £2. £2. That's amazing. But I just really wanted to rave about the fact that I love this kind of idea of a personalised palette, and you get to choose the shades that you want inside it. And listen to this click. Oh, I'm going to really quickly show you what I have in my white palette. There's 8 eyeshadows in this palette and then 4 highlighters. I really wanted to mix it up a little bit, especially if I was going to take this on holiday or anywhere. Look how pretty it is! Look at that mirror though. That is friggin' huge. Friggin' massive. I have all my matte shades on the top. So I have 4 matte shades, 4 shimmer shades, and then 4 highlighters. We have Mink E143, and then we have Cinnamon here, which is E146. And then moving along, we have Copper. Copper is such a gorgeous shade. If you're going to get any matte shade, get the copper one. It's like an orangey brown. It's stunning. It's beautiful. And then we have Chocolate Cream E127. They all blend so nice and they're so milky soft. So gorgeous. And then down here we have Ibiza E142. And then we move along to Starstruck E125. Bullet. This is such a gorgeous coppery purple shade. So nice. And this is E147. Then we have one of my favourites, E130, New York. Welcome to New York! The highlighters and contour are £3. So the highlighter down here, H112, is Lightning. This is called Bronze and it's the H103. And then we have Gold. I mean, it's pretty much what it says on the tin, and that is H106. And then our last shade, Tropical, and that's H111. I totally recommend trying these out, but especially if you want to try out a new eyeshadow range for a cheap value price. Cannot wait to use all of these shadows and highlighters. So there was one little birthday present that I couldn't find before recording the birthday haul video. So I thought I'd show it you in this one, because it actually has been one of my favourite little makeup bags to use throughout January. I've actually put the palette, my little gold palette, in here just to keep it safe. But this bag is freaking cute. I love it. So this makeup bag has the quote, "Throw kindness around, like confetti. I'm pretty sure Zoella has a bag that says like this. I think it was released in our Christmas range, but you can only get it in a 3-pack. So when I got this as a birthday present, I was so chuffed. It's got these rose gold and gold little dots all over it in this metallic sheen, and the font is like that. It's just so cute. It's made by this brand and it's called With Honor. I really want to know where you can get this from, because I want to know if they do anything more like this. And it's the perfect kind of quote that you want to read before you go to work, when you're doing your makeup, like when you're getting ready. Throw kindness around like confetti. Why not? Next, we're going to be moving on to edible. I still haven't eaten everything I got for Christmas or my birthday. There are a certain packet of sweets that I've been loving for, let's say, I think about 4 or 5 months. I'm not even kidding. And I am addicted to these. I try and get these as often as I can because they only sell them at Asda, as far as I'm aware. That's the only place I've seen them. I've tried looking at the places, but they don't seem to sell them anywhere else. That is these Frutella Super Shakes. Oh my gosh. If you love Frutella sweets, you're gonna love these, because when I first had these, I was like, wow, these taste amazing. And then that was it. That was my addiction, never ending. They're so nice, and for this big bag, they're only £1. The flavours you get are strawberry, banana, and mango. And the mango one, oh my gosh, it's like heaven. It's my favourite. It's so nice, so good. I need to go pick some more up after I've eaten this packet, because this is the addiction. They're just so, 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 so nice. So if you haven't tried these, I'm ordering you to go try them. I'm not even kidding. They're so good. But as soon as Christmas and the January sales were kind of over, Tesco and a lot of the supermarket shops, shall we say, started to release their Easter range of chocolates. And they brought back my absolute favourite packet of chocolate mini eggs from last year. These were released last year and I was hoping they were going to bring them out this year, and they did. They are the Galaxy Golden Eggs. Oh my goodness, you have to try these if you haven't already. Last year I went absolutely crazy on them, and especially after Easter, Tesco knocked them down to like 50p or 30p, and I just stocked up on them. They're just so good. They're basically these galaxy little eggs covered in this kind of gold shimmer, and then inside the galaxy chocolate eggs are these little bits of crunchy honeycomb, and they're just so nice. If you like honeycomb, and if you like crunchy, and if you like galaxy, then try this. As most of you Disney fans will be aware, the Moana Disney film was released in December, and ever since I went to see the film with my best friend, I have been listening to the soundtrack non-stop. Like, it's been my go-to music when I'm really upset or really feeling down. It's just been the go-to soundtrack, especially when I've been in the bath. I just sing the lyrics to my heart's content, but I have it on my phone and it's literally on repeat. Like, once I've finished the album, I want to re-listen to it, like, straight away. I love every track, and How Far I'll Go is such an empowering song. It just gets you through the day. And then you have Dwayne Johnson singing You're Welcome in his such funny, hilarious voice. I just love it. The last thing I wanted to include in my favourites is the Star Wars film Rogue One. Now, I put off seeing this for quite some time because ever since we were little, there has been this tradition where as a Johnson family, we go and watch the Star Wars films at the cinema together. And couldn't get any time where we were all free, so we waited until my birthday, or just before my birthday. And I love it. I knew it was going to be as good as it was. I mean, for one, you have Darth Vader back in it. You also have a cameo from R2-D2 and C-3PO. And then you have the stunning, brilliant cameo at the end of Leia, Princess Leia. So, yeah, I love that. I did not expect them to put Princess Leia into it, but I'm so glad she is. And I saw the film after the news of Carrie Fisher, and it just made me cry so much. Like, I was pretty much calm throughout the whole of the film, and then when you saw the back of Princess Leia, I just started to cry because, oh, it was just... And the animation for not only Darth Vader's, like, commander, But Leia as well, the animation, the technology that film has gone to these days is insane. She just, it's just, I can't praise it enough. Wow, cinematography is going up there. It's rising, it's still going. I mean, I look at films and I'm just like, how can you get any better than that? And they can. They literally can. That is all for my favourites. I've really enjoyed this video. If you want to see more of these videos, please give this video a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel and comment below. I love you guys and I'll see you again soon. Bye! But it is the Love Hearts perfume. Yeah, it's just the Love Hearts perfume. I just.